Julie Darling here. Brr, it's cold at the top of the mountain. I wanted to talk for a minute about patterns and limitations and capacity. So, I'm gonna start by sharing with you one of my patterns that I've been playing out my entire life. And the thing about patterns is you can embrace them and recognize them when you're in the beginning of a cycle, and you can embrace that and just ride that energy and that flow, or you can work to change that. So it just depends on if the pattern is working for you or not. So today I'm up at the ski hill, and I had a major breakthrough with my skiing last night. I have some equipment that I got in Canada. It's a little closer to expert gear than my abilities are. I'm a good solid blue and black diamond skier, and I'm just here to have fun. I don't really attack the mountain. I pet the mountain, and I like it that way. But I'm always looking to improve, right? So yesterday I had a breakthrough where I grew into my ski gear. So that was kind of the idea when I got it, was that this stuff is a little over my head, but I'm gonna be skiing a lot, and I'm gonna keep improving, and like I'm just taking that for granted. And that's exactly what's happened. Yeah, so that got me reflecting on my learning patterns. So one of my archetypes or roles that is really central in my life is the lifetime learner. And I love to learn, I love to try new things, I love to get outside of my comfort zone, I love to feel goofy when I get it totally wrong and laugh at myself, and sometimes I get really, really frustrated. So I'm going to talk to you about my process of learning and what that looks like. So I'm a really slow learner. I take time and I listen very carefully and I observe. I learn through observation like crazy. I'm like this big sponge and I notice a lot of details that most people spend their whole life not noticing. And I see patterns. And this is just part of who I am and how I'm built. And the thing is I ask a lot of questions that people don't know the answer to because they've never noticed these patterns before. And so what I've figured out is that I have to figure how to do stuff by myself because I'm not built in a way where I can stay on the surface. Like if you think of a boat floating in the water, that boat is only sitting on maybe 10% of the water, right? It's just sitting up at the surface. And underneath that boat is 90% of the water. And I swim in deep waters. I have to dive deep. It's just who I am. I can't not do it. To the frustration of many people around me who tried to teach me and help me do things. And to my own frustration as well. So the thing about that is I also tend to make things harder on myself than they need to be. Because if I could just stay on the surface, I could get the hang of it and I could learn things a lot faster. I could just pick things up by the feel of it a lot faster. And that works for many, many, many people, and that's awesome. And in some ways, I'm kind of envious. And because it seems like I have to work a lot harder for the same things than other people do, is how it feels. And in some ways, that's true, and in other ways, that's false. Because there's a lot of people out there who are just like me, who need to go deeper, who know that there's something more to this, and who feel really uncomfortable when they're being dismissed and pushed back to the surface, when they're trying to swim in deep waters. I tend to attract people who are kind of like me, who like to have these deeper conversations and who want to go down into the water and play. Because there's a lot of beautiful stuff down there. Like there's fish and there's dolphins and there's seaweed and there's the light changes colors. And it's not easy down there. Like you have to hold your breath for a long time to swim in deep waters. And it gets uncomfortable. And sometimes you stay down longer than you mean to. And then you're in a big hurry to swim back to the surface. And you have to be careful and, you know, blow your nose to make your ears pop. And yeah, and so anyway, I just want to really encourage you that, especially if you've worked with coaches in the past or even just teachers, like growing up, coaches in sports, there's all these times in life where we ask these questions, where we ask these questions and we get kind of dismissive answers. And I just want to let you know that all that means is you're just not finding the right match for you. That's all it means. It's not a judgment about anything against you. It's not that their way is better, even though more people seem to be doing it at the surface level. It's okay to find your own path, and it's okay to not fit into the system as it works, as it's supposed to work or whatever. Because, you know, here's the thing, is as easy as it is for us to treat each other in society like we're all a bunch of robots, and I know robotics and artificial intelligence are actually becoming a real thing in people's lives. And I just more than anything want to remind you that we're all just actually people. And we're supposed to be people. We're not supposed to be robots. We're not supposed to be doing everything the exact same way. And not everything needs to be turned into a blueprint or a map or three quick and easy steps. Although it's nice because you have something to grab onto when you're new to have three quick and easy steps. Life can't be boiled down into three quick and easy steps. So anyway, I just wanted to share that with you because I'm leveling up in a lot of my patterns right now. And I think there's a lot of people in the world who are right now. And I just want to be connected with you if you're one of those people because, gosh, you know, things are shifting. Everything's changing and it's happening fast. And I think the more we can support each other and be there for each other and appreciate each other, the more fun we're gonna have. 'Cause things have been kind of heavy. Things have been kind of hard. And, you know, maybe it's time to lighten up a little and just embrace our humanity because there's a lot of beauty in it. Like, the human condition is about joy and compassion and grace and learning to make your way through this strange world that we live in. So, all right, my hands are about to freeze. So I'm going to give you a quick view and then that's it. So until next time, stay in abundance. Bye. That's the desert out there. So I'm skiing in the desert. I don't know how many times I've tripped out on this. Every single time I come out here, I trip out because it's all the desert and the arroyos out there. I love it. Oh, boy.